This is simplifying radicals again, but now with variables. So just a quick review. Two numbers that give you 32 are 4 and 8. So we always break it down into its prime factors. Put them in the radical. So there's 5 of them. And then remember, with radicals, we're looking for groups of 2. It's asking what number times itself. So that number is being multiplied by itself. What number times itself? 2. So that means we can take out 2 2s, and 2 times 2 is 4. Everything here is multiplication. And there's our answer, 4 square root of 2. So with variables, it's exactly the same thing. So we've already done that. I don't know why I'm going to break it down again. We've already done it here. So we get 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. I'm going to do exactly the same thing with the variables. And you just circle groups of 2, pairs. And always put a multiply between them. So we have also have a pair of x's and a pair of y's. So on the outside, we have 2 times 2 and then xy. So that's 4xy. And what's left still in the radical is the 2 and the y. So that's simplifying radicals. So the whole idea is that it's asking what number, that's what a square root is, what number multiplied by itself. So we're multiplying a 2 by itself, a 2 by itself, an x by itself, and a y by itself. And we have an extra y and an extra 2. And that's all you have to do. All right? So you can do the same thing. I'm going to do this one a little different now. Same exact idea. You can always just write it out. But what if you have z to 11? I don't feel like writing out 11 z's. So we still do our number the same way, but just write the variables this time. Just like that. And we're still going to circle. So we have a pair of 2's, pair of 2's, same as before. And now you have to ask yourself, how many pairs of x's are there? And what that basically is division. So if you take 2 and divide it by 2, it tells you there is one pair of x's. And then same with 3. If we divide by 2, it'll say that we have one pair and one left over. So we have one remainder 1, which means we can take out 1, but 1 will be left in there. And then the same thing with the 11. If we take 11, divide it by 2, it gives us 5. Remainder 1. So that means we take out 5 and there's 1 left in. And if you kind of look at this now, if you see the odds are not going to have an even number of pairs. They're always going to have that odd number, right? Sorry, the odds are not going to be even, obviously, because they have that odd little number that's going to sit there. So anytime you have an odd, there's always going to be one of them left inside. Anytime you have an even, they're all going to come out. So let's see what we have now. 2 times 2 is 4. An x, a y, and a z5. And what's left in the radical is 2y and z. And that's it. You're just looking for pairs. So if you divide each exponent, it'll tell you how many pairs there are. And whatever's left here, that's what's left inside. It's your remainder, so it's remaining in the radical. That's what these two are. So we had one z and one y left in, but 2 is even. All right, let's see if you kind of get this. So you can do either method. You can write them all out and then keep circling, or you can divide your variables. All right, so try those two right there. Hit pause and give them a shot. And there's the answers. All right, so I like the division method, obviously. And the more you do it, eventually you'll just do it in your head. 4 divided by 2 is 2. Done. 13 divided by 2 is 6, and that means there's 1 left over. All right, these are our special ones now. So you notice these have additions in them. So the first one, you have to find the multiply. Anything with a plus must be put in parentheses, and this one's already done. So we're looking for the same idea. So with 81, that's 9 times 9, and then that's x plus 2, x plus 2. So again, we're looking for pairs. And that means we have a pair of x plus 2's, you got to leave the parentheses, and a pair of 9's. So then my answer is 9x plus 2, which is which gives you 9x plus 18. And there you go. So on this one, what we have to do, the only way to get this into a multiplication is to factor it. And in order for it to be able to simplify, it has to be a perfect square. And there's our perfect pair. So we circle it, so we get x plus 3, and that's our answer. So that's what you do when you see pluses. You just factor, and that'll give you a pair. And if it's already done, you just take out your pairs. Everything's about pairs. All right, this is a special note. This is not going to come into play with us, but I just have to cover it. So what's happening with square roots? If you have a nice number, so that's 6 and 6, x and x, we take out the x. Take out this, so it's 6x, right? What really is happening, though, is this is an absolute value of x. Because what happens when you put any number in here and square it? It turns positive. But once we pull it out, it's x. So we have to technically put an absolute value there. Now, I don't want to see this on our homework, where we're assuming that all the x's are positive. I just want you to remember that for later stuff. You'll see when we get there. But so whenever you have a square inside of a radical, there's technically an absolute value. So like this one, you would think, oh, well, the square and the square root, we just have two of those, right? And you'd go negative 7x, negative 7x. So that would just be negative 7x. Well, that would be wrong. And it's because of this. This square is going to turn everything inside positive. So it's really 7x, 7x, which is 7x. That's your pair. So when you are actually canceling this, it will delete the negative as well. So on this one, it would actually look like this. There's technically an absolute value there, just to remember it, okay? And same thing here. There's an absolute value there. I forgot it. So see, that's how it is. Now, I don't want the answer to look like this. Don't worry about the absolute values. I just wanted to tell you just to be aware of it. Whenever you square and square root something like this, it deletes the negative. Turns it positive. All right, thank you.